Hey guys, so for today's video, I wanted to do some summer room decor DIYs for you because I feel like I haven't done room decor in a really long time. I know that summer is getting really close for a lot of you, so if you want to, let me know in the comments down below what day you get out from school for the summer. I'm really having trouble talking today. I'm so sorry about that. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and get started with the video. If you're new here, be sure to click that subscribe button down below, and I'm gonna go ahead and get started. So our first DIY is a Phases of the Moon wall hanging, and this is inspired by something I saw on a blog, so I'm going to link that blog down below because it is so amazing. So I'm starting off with some white clay, which I just got from Walmart, and basically all I'm going to do is just rub it in my hands to kind of warm it up a little bit, and that way it's more moldable and easier to use. Now you could either have white clay as the base color or black. I did more white and then just slowly started to add in the black, but it's just up to you. And then I just kind of twisted it to give it kind of more of a marble effect. And then I flattened it with just a rolling pin. Just be careful with what surface you're working on, because I had a piece of like bright construction paper under this and it ended up getting super stuck to it and it was really hard to get off. So just make sure you're working on a surface that it won't get stuck on. So now it's time to shape the pieces, and I had 9 circles total. So I made a crescent piece, one with a flat edge, and then I made this circle just into a smaller circle, and then I have the regular circle, another small circle, and then another flat edge piece and another crescent piece. So that's kind of what it looks like. You've got these 2 crescents. You can see what I did. It's hard to explain. Last but not least, I'm going in with an X-Acto knife to create a hole at the top of each piece so I can thread them. And then I'm just tying knots to each one and stringing them all together so I can hang it up on my wall. Now, this mostly stayed up pretty well. I had a few pieces that tore through like the thread through the edge of it, so I did pin those up, but I think it looks really cool and I love it next to my desk. Now, I've seen these like DIY like grid inspiration boards all over Pinterest, and I think they're amazing. So for mine, I wanted to make a cute one that was summer inspired, so I searched pineapple outline and I just printed one off and trimmed all the edges down. And then I bought a piece of corkboard and I used that to create a little tiny pineapple corkboard. So I took my outline and just traced it with a really thin Sharpie. And this is really easy to do because you don't have to stress about the edges too much, because you can always trim the areas that you mess up. And it doesn't take too much corkboard either, so I saved the other pieces and I made like a triangle one and a square one. Not that you really care about that, but you can use the rest of it, which I think is cool because I don't like to waste materials. Anyways, so then I'm going in with my thin Sharpie and I'm just outlining it. I planned to color this, but I actually really liked how it looked with just a black outline. So then I just put some notes on there, things to remember over the summertime, and put it up on this grid that I've already put in my room. I also printed off some Polaroids that were just super bright and colorful. And like I said, you guys, I know I am not the first person to do this. I see these all over Pinterest. I know you can get a grid like this at Urban Outfitters, and I think just adding pictures that are seasonal, a corkboard, and some twinkle lights are the perfect way to make a summer inspiration board. So I don't know why, but like really bright donuts remind me of summertime. I think it's because of a giant donut inflatable. So I just wanted to make a really cute summer doormat. So for this, I just took a doormat from Target. It was like $9. And then I'm taking this white Sharpie and just kind of trying to make a half circle. And don't get discouraged, because nobody can draw a perfect circle. It's okay. So I'm just trimming it down as best I can. And this is a little difficult, but it's not too bad. Then I'm taking some bright colored spray paint, and I took this poster board and just outlined it so it kind of looked like frosting, and covered this with really bright pink spray paint. And then after I did that, I took this little cutout that looks kind of like a sprinkle. These were way too big, by the way, but that's okay. And I just made some light blue and purple sprinkles. And then I went in and I traced the back of it again after it had dried. And then I cut out one smaller circle so that it actually looks like a donut. This is super cheap and really easy. I think it's really fun and bright, and you should definitely try it out. So this last DIY is kind of a bonus idea, because it's kind of hard to show the entire thing to you guys, but I wanted to just show you the idea. So basically, Urban Outfitters has these really cool pillows that are like these really detailed, doodled, cursive pillows. So what I did was I just printed one out, and then on the back of a blank pillow, I just drew like a little tiny outline in pencil of how big I wanted my letter. And then I just went in and made really, really tiny like scribble designs. And the thing is, if you look closely, my drawings look really, really bad. Like honestly, they're not good. They're not even. But when you look at it far away, it just looks kind of cool altogether. So this is why I don't want you to be discouraged by this, because I am by no means like an amazing artist or anything. All I did was draw like some flowers and leaves and like curly shapes, and that's it. And all together, it looks amazing. Like I showed my mom and she didn't even think I actually made it, but just don't be discouraged. It does take a while. It probably took me like an hour and a half to draw, but I think it looks amazing, and I really do think you could do this if you took the time to try it.
So thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions about anything, be sure to leave them down below, and I'll see you later. Bye.